Ahoy, friends. Welcome to Building the Alpha Dory. I'm Dan, and this is a project to build a 1890s era racing dory for sailing, rowing, and cruising along the New England coast. Today we're hoping to get the second garboard plank scarfed together, glued up. So let's get to it. All right, so that's 10 nails. Straight enough to reuse. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. All right, so we got ten pieces of scrap wood to nail down. So what we'll do is drill so that the nails don't split them when they go in. Those are ready to go. Got the glue right here. I've already swept a board clear on this side of the boat. So what we'll do is so the straight edge is going to be here. and then this will go down on top of that. So we're looking like we're lined up pretty good over here. Yeah, top edge, top edge, and top edge. Yeah, got it going in the right direction down here. So we're all the right sides up, and I mean, that's how the scarves are cut anyway. So at this point, you know, you're kind of, you wouldn't want to recut the scarves because you'd lose so much length. You know, it's by having the right edge up, we're gaining maybe an inch and a half, 2 inches. And by recutting the scarf, you lose 3 inches. So it's not worth changing anything anyway. But you know, things worked out, so that's awesome. Get our wax paper down. Well, that's 7 inches worth, and or a little bit more. Curl. There goes. I already checked the floor for any irregularities, specifically like old glue drips that I knocked them up with a chisel, so we've got a nice flat surface to glue on, to nail down and onto, so that's important. Looks good. So we'll try to get pretty close to where we want to be, where we want to end up. Now I'm putting that
that straight edge on it to check the heights of the relative two planks. Make sure we're in a good spot there. Okay, this one is a little bit low, so we're going to move it away. This one is a little bit below this one, so. Looks good, and then we'll recheck this here. Okay, yeah, both of those are looking good. Alright, and we'll see how it looks when we get the glue on, but hopefully we won't need to move them again. So, set that weight on there. Hopefully keep it from moving. I'll grab the railroad tie from over here. Set this on this one. Railroad track. Set that one on that one. Alright, we should be good to glue. So we got our nailing pieces here, clamping pieces. And what I'll do is I'll just flip this stuff will wash right off your hands as long as you get it before it dries, so it's a real easy cleanup. This is already down onto the wax paper. So I had a ton of squeeze out on the glue squeeze out on the last last garboard with that we get up. So don't have to put quite as much glue on this time. It's always better to have too much glue than too little. You don't want to make a glue starved joint, but you know, see if we can tone it back a little bit, the amount of glue, because we just had a ton of squeeze out on the bottom edge. Oh, yeah, kind of a rainy day today, wet one. And dry in the shop here. one of the big benefits of building small boats as opposed to shipbuilding. Get yourself and your tools in out of the wet and the weather. Okay. Nothing, honey. So you can kind of get a sense for how these, even with the tight bond, these flaps like to slide a little bit. So you can only imagine how what a pain it is with the epoxy, which is really why I started nailing these things, because you cannot clamp these long ramps with a lot of glue on them. You cannot just clamp them with epoxy. The boards are just going to keep moving all over the place. It's crazy how much they want to slide. And you're just trying to squeeze that epoxy and it does not squeeze. So you really need a mechanical fastener to anchor the location of the board on the glue joint. So we're gonna start on that feathered edge like we did last time, and so the way we've got it set up now, this is the top edge, this is the straight edge, this is the back here, this is the top edge, the back is back there. So when we put this on to the boat, we're going to be picking it up like this. So this is going to be the outside of the planking. So we'll put three nails right along this edge. One, two, three. And then we'll put two nails further back. This square is still set at 3 inches from when we did this on the other garboard plank. So we'll go here. That'll be within 3 inches of the scarf. We'll go here. That'll be within 3 inches. Yeah, we're good. On to the next one.
check the heights here. Looks good. Let's get this thing nailed down. So again, we're going to be, this is the outside edge here. So we got three on the feather. And two on the 3-inch, within the 3-inch mark. Yeah, that's good. All right. Huh? Okay, now let's sight along this puppy. See how we did for getting it straight. Okay, so I'm tweaking this one just a tiny bit that way. Looks good. And then I'm going to move that back one maybe a little bit less than half an inch, maybe a quarter of an inch, same direction. Not far. Honestly, just to the line here, really. I'll go take a look at that again, just to be sure. I didn't need to move this one quite as far as that. Spot on. Okay, well, looks like I got a, all right, well, thanks for, tuning in, and, yeah, stop by next time when we, start cutting the bevels on the on that garboard plank. Anyway, God bless, and catch you guys later.